You are in tune to Eats, Beats, and Rhymes. That's right. You're back for another episode of Who Do You Got? And I am your host, Yo Jules DJ. Welcome back to another episode. We get busy. We do five rounds of fire. Another singles battle. It's only right. Rock the Bell just hit this past weekend, so you know what time it is. Let's talk about the man himself, LL Cool J. Tonight's topic of battle. Ladies and gentlemen, let's talk about best LL Cool J records of all time. Eats, Beats, and Rhymes. Let's make some noise. Yeah. Y'all do sabe, as we all say. Everybody says it. Let's go ahead and introduce the rest of the room. Like I said, for those who don't know, Rock the Bells, Hill Festival, first of all, shout out to LL for getting the rights back to that name. Now the festival is under his umbrella. He's doing his thing. I believe this is the second annual under his tutelage, if you will, doing it in Queens. That's awesome. Happened this past weekend. If you catch some footage online, check it out. Definitely a dope, dope show. So again, it's only right we had to talk about the man himself. Uncle L,
Future of the Funk.
Future of the Funk, that's what it was. Thank you, Ike. Like I said, so let's talk about the man himself, LL Cool J. Let's go around the room, and like I said, let's introduce everybody and find out what everybody's pick is for tonight's battle. It's going to get interesting. Like I said, best of LL. And don't forget, we do this every Monday night live on Twitch here, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And like I said, it's a thing we do. It's a vibe. It's a hip-hop vibe. We get it popping in. You know what I mean? And again, tonight's a singles battle, LL Cool J, best LL Cool J records of all time. Let's get down to it. Let's start with my man all the way on the Queens side of things, Triple C, Quick Fast, Mr. Fast, Triple C from Queens. Triple C, what is going on, sir?
I was expecting to go first, but here I am.
There you is. Look at this. See? Boom. Here you is. Here we are.
Who would have thought? You don't have to give nothing.
I got to take it to the original, the first album. I Can't Live Without My Radio.
Oh, snap. Oh, LL Cool J, classic, My Radio. I Can't Live Without My Radio. Brought to us by Triple C. Triple C not messing around. Or Triple C might have learned from his previous games. He can't be picking, 14 tracks from 14 Shops at the Dome for an album track. You know what I'm saying? It ain't going to happen tonight, Triple C. You know what I'm saying? That is not what's going on. Let's be clear.
Pink Cookies on that album. Relax.
This is true. But we all love the remix. We know this even more. Regardless, a gem in it. Look, he's throwing his eyes and scale like Easy Mo B. You know what I'm talking about. Let's keep it pushing. Let's talk to the restroom. Triple C obviously making it difficult for the rest of the gentlemen in the room. Let's keep pushing. Let's go with my man DJ Hobo, as a matter of fact, since you had something to say so fast. DJ Hobo, Triple T Radio, VA 2 up, 2 down. What is up, sir?
What up? I was not prepared to go next, but you know what? I feel like partying tonight. I'm going Jingling Baby.
I do want
to give you a chance to clarify real quick, Hobo, just to make sure. Are we talking about the remix or are we talking about the album version? Both versions are on the album, but there are two different versions.
You know the one I'm talking about.
Marley Marl remix. Gotcha. Say less. Say less. My bad. I didn't mean to.
Those kinds of questions.
Put the fofo down, DJ Hobo. Put the fofo down. Listen, Hope we're not messing around. He's party central today. He's getting it going. Like I said, he's jingling, party, baby. Bro. You know what I mean? Let's see what else is going on, my man. The real Cool B in the building, all the way from the east. East coast to the west coast. My man representing both coasts. What's going on, sir?
I'm good. How are you, my good friend? What's going down?
I'm fine, thank you. How are you?
I am.
That's headroom and shit. Right.
Yes, there is a glitch in the system. Okay.
Yo, shout out to Project Elevate in the building. I see everybody in the chat room. Shout out to Ike Infamous in the building. Shout out to us in the building because we represent the building all the time. What's going on? Cool Breeze, LL Cool J's greatest hits, greatest songs. Who do you got?
Since Hobo took my song, I'm going to.
Pobrecito.
I hope you go against each other. I'm going with Rock the Bells, man.
Oh snap, dude is going with classics.
Oh man.
I hope we match up, Hobo. I hope we do.
He calling you out.
Ooh, he's spiking calling you out. Please, I like it. I like it. Yes, let's go.
He's calling you out.
You can't get under my skin today. I'm partying today. I don't care.
Oh,
we jingling today.
You took my record, man.
Listen, we see what's going on. You hear the ad libs in the background, so it's only right we go with the ad lib king on EBR. Let's talk to my man DJ Scanless, aka Baba Midi, the ad lib EBR king, sir. You quick to drop the ums and the ahs in the background, so I gotta ask you first, who you umming and ahming for tonight?
Ah, man, my record got taken. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, snap. Which one was your record? Which one?
Rock the Bells. Rock the Bells. Snap. But I came prepared because I figured some type of shenanigans was gonna go down.
I'm trying to think how I want to play my hand.
Let me see. So we got I Need a Radio. Got Rock. Let's go.
Jiggling Baby, My Radio, and Rock the Bells.
Go with Hey Lover.
Nah, man.
Calm down. To go Hey Lover. Great record.
There's a good record. I'm trying to think. There's really a lot to choose from. I'm just trying to think of potential matchups. You know what I mean?
Be clear. This man's got catalog upon catalog. Yeah. He's the Michael Bolton of hip hop. Be clear.
Yeah. All right, so I'm gonna go on bad. That was one of my joints in there. There's another hand I could play. You know what I mean? Another hand I could play, but I'll go this way.
Listen, be clear. You guys can definitely step out of the ages. Okay, he went into the 90s. He went into the 2000s. And y'all know, it's all right. You can do that. I mean, like I said, but you're allowed to choice. Listen, LL is the man. One of the first to really put it down in the game like that. Let's be honest. Threw Def Jam on his back. He made it happen. Mm-hmm. But again, we're talking following sequels. I mean, we're talking about LL Cool J's greatest records of all time. Let's keep it pushing. My man Ike Infamous in the building. Represent Ally Strong All Day, as you know. Sir, what is going on? What is the LL Cool J song of your preference tonight?
What up, man? What am I supposed to do now, huh? It's all fucked up now.
You got plenty of hits.
But I wasn't prepared for the other ones. You know what I mean?
That's how you play your hand now.
Yeah, man. So you know what? I'm going to just say fuck it, since I know the game is rigged towards me anyway. It usually gets me out first. You know what I'm saying? I think I'm going to go with, and correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm going to go with Ill Bomb.
Okay.
Stepping away from the shadow of the DuckTales crowd over here. I like that.
The triple C card today. I like it.
Okay.
What am I supposed to do when y'all took my records? What am I supposed to do when y'all took my record?
I mean, there's so many to choose from, brother.
Yeah, I know, but you know, Jiggling Baby's my shit, man.
Yeah, it depends on what was picked. Yeah.
Even people in the chat room are picking joints. Shout out DJ Shazam X. Like I said, people picking joints.
That's a good question. He said, which Rock the Bells? Because he said, Rock the Bells part two is really part one.
Uh oh. DJ Scanless, what do you say to this question?
Say it again. He said Rock the Bells part two.
Which Rock the Bells? He said, because Rock the Bells part two is really part one.
Rock the Bells part two. Actually, I'm not gonna lie. I'm not super familiar with this.
The one they say all the time.
I just thought that was part one.
Well, first off, I picked Rock the Bells.
Right.
Word. My bad. I'm looking at myself, you got all flustered for no reason.
No, but he actually.
That just shows that this scale is not paying attention.
That's all.
Go ahead. I'm just saying, scale looking like that kid in class who they ask him the question.
Mr. September also he co-signed that. He said Rock the Bells 2 was first, but 1 was better. So which one you going with there, Breeze?
I'm going with the classic Rock the Bells, Hobo, the one that they play on the radio. That one.
Now, just so I'm clear, so when I look up the song, is there a version of 1 and 2 that I'm looking up? Is it on the album? Is it the album version, the one that I'm looking for? Like I just need a little clarity before I start picking out records on the Spotify list.
You know what? Let me check and I'll get back to you on that one.
Fair enough. Thank you, sir. Fair enough.
Damn, Malcontent, how you going to come in the chat and then dip out? So what's up?
He's trying to look for this.
You know what it is? I think I have a good feeling Malcontent, who is going to join us tonight, like I said, might have dipped out the back because all his records probably got chosen. Let's be clear. let's just talk about what everybody's showing their hands. And he's like, damn, I don't have anything else. So I don't know. We'll have to see.
There's so many to choose from. Stop that. Come on, Malcontent. You got to get back in here.
That's the whole entire thing. You see, I want you all to look at it from my perspective. As I come up to the singles again, when I approach the singles game of East Beats and Rhymes, I try to figure out, are we doing you know, like who's gonna have what? Like Scan said, how is it gonna battle up? You know what I mean? I'm Bad and Jiggling Baby and Rock the Bells. It's nice, you know what I mean? But there's so many. I come up there with my favorite one. Boo! Early Exit. You know what I mean? Out.
Like, what the That's why I got a
you
list.
You don't know. You don't know what the machines. You don't know what the machines are doing and what they're gonna say. So.
Now, you know, I usually I'm on your side, but that sounds like a cop out.
Mm-hmm. It would come from you today since you stole my record, sir. Oh.
Hey, I would say this.
Attention, pickpocket. Pickpocket. Attention, pickpocket.
It all depends on who went first. He got the first choice. If I would have went first, I would have picked Rock the Bell, so you would have been mad at me. So, it's, you know. To every show, this show right here is teacher's own, man. You got a whole
Okay, I got you. I got you.
It's no crying.
So you just had to sit my $5 ass down.
You're gonna stick with that
choice. $5 ass down before I make change.
Another classic 80s. Listen, we got another guest in the building. My man Malcolm Tent in the building representing, sir. Thank you for joining us straight from the chat room. Literally, he was in the chat room a second ago. Now he's in our room right here. Shout out to the man Malcolm Tent in the building. What is on, sir?
I actually joined because, you know, I got the invite from Hobo, but then Jules kept me on mute and kept my video off. So I was like, okay, maybe I was too late. So I just joined.
I know. The Mandarin started early. I want
this is nonsense. This is the person we've been off the whole time.
And everybody thinks I just be making up noise. You know what I mean?
Not at all. You could clearly see Malcontent trying to get into the room early. And I saw him and I was like, oh snap, Malcontent's in the building. Because shout out to the good Reverend Doctor. He wasn't able to make it on time today. Like I said, so we called an audible. We had the good man Malcontent step in.
No, it's all good.
I thought you got nervous. I thought everybody picked your records. You had to step away.
Never nervous. And plus,
Nervous. Oh, snap.
Cool J is my dude. I've been a fan of Cool J forever, man. So this is right up my alley. And first of all, Jules, shout out for the Molly Ringwald, 16 candles, whatever.
You know what I'm saying? We in a certain space today. You know what I'm saying? We in a certain space.
So I just want to make sure I heard everything right. Now, I did hear Jiggling Baby remix was picked. I heard.
Let me run through the list real quick, real fast. Yeah. So just to refresh everybody's memory, because we're going to wait for Malcontent's choice, right? He wants to carefully make his choice. We had Triple C starting with Can't Live Without My Radio. DJ Hobo following up with a Jiggling Baby remix. Going with Cool Breeze's Rock the Bells. Apparently, it might be version one. We'll find out along the way.
I did.
No, thank you. We got I'm Bad, pointed out by DJ Scandalous. And then we got Ill Bomb, brought to us by Ike Infamous. Malcontent, what is your choice of best LL Cool J record of all time?
Ooh. This is tough, but I'm just going to go with one of my personal favorites, Jack the Ripper.
Ooh. Ooh. Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay.
I'd expect Fisher that. Song. Okay, all right.
Well, song. You know, I think you might lose today, then.
Oh, wow. It's all good.
Personal story.
Yeah, okay, cool.
When I say personal choice, you always lose, but when you pick outside of your personal choice, you won back-to-back. I'm watching you, buddy. I know.
You said I should have picked I Need Love, the biggest hit. No, I mean, I'm not doing that. I'm going with my
Project Elevator said I Need Love was LL's best record.
Yeah, it's his biggest.
It's a big record. Mm-hmm. Classic record too.
It's a classic, and it was such a bold record, right? Such a bold record.
It's actually funny too if we start off with this, because in comparison to today's climate, that record would be a simp record right now.
Yeah. Straight up.
They'd be calling LL a munch right now.
They'd be crying. LL would be a munch. You'd be a Drake munch.
But listen,
we are here to celebrate this man. We are here to celebrate this man. Rock the bells.
Everyone can't do that record, though. Everyone can't do that record.
True.
So LL's a man. Queens,
that's a fact. You know? Again, people in the chat room are putting their choices down. Like I said, shout out to everybody that joins us every Monday night, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Like I said, if you're familiar with the singles battle, basically March Madness style, we're going to put these six records up in a jar right here, find out what the competition, what the battles will be by random choice right now. So I'm going to go ahead and find out what the first two battles will be. Randomly picking. So you see I'm not cheating. Here we go, because I get accused of it all the time. We got two numbers right here. We are looking at contestants number one and number two, My Radio by Triple C, going up against Jiggling Baby remix by DJ Hobo. Uh-oh. Oh, snap.
Damn, Triple C, I always got to do it to you, son. Pause. But I'm
He letting you know that you didn't stand a chance.
You stupid, Skin.
I'm going with what started.
LL Munch J? Is that what you said? LL Munch J? Get foul. No respect for your elders. No respect. Moving on to round number two. Picked out two more numbers here at the draw. Let's go ahead and keep it pushing here. Number five and number six. Looking like Ill Bomb by Ike Infamous going against Jack the Ripper by Malcontent.
Ooh. Oh, snap. Okay.
That one's kind of, I feel like that one fits. Pause.
Yeah. I like that matchup.
The game's rigged, man.
Ain't no rigging. Ain't no truck drivers around here. You better stop all that. Just keep it moving. You already know what the last 2 hours are going to be. We're looking at contestant number four and number three. We're looking at Rock the Bells by Cool Breeze going up against I'm Bad by DJ Scandalous, the final of the three rounds. This is the fight for this evening, sir. Three rounds. We're talking again. Can't Live Without My Radio going up against Jingling Baby, the remix. Ill Bomb going up against Jack the Ripper. And last but not least, Rock the Bells going up against I'm Bad. What an evening of hip hop. What an evening. Oh my goodness. Rock the Bells. Let me write this down so we can start the festivities. Mm-hmm. This is about to be a good one right here. I like where this is going. And for those who don't know, like I said, every Monday night, here we are live, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on Twitch. Don't forget to check us out on YouTube, by the way. We got dope content dropping on YouTube on a regular basis. New episodes every week. A little more sauce and flash on these episodes. Like I said, a lot of cool artwork, a lot of cool sound effects and dope just material that we talk about. A lot of stuff that you guys don't get to see behind the scenes. And last but not least, don't forget to check us out on all your audio podcast needs. Triple C's got us covered, making sure you can hear us on the road anywhere you go. Let's go ahead and start round number one. Ay, ay, ay. This is a tough one right here. Like, again, brought to us by my man Triple C and DJ Hobo. We're going to start off things, like I said, by going with Triple C's choice first, because obviously your man got chosen first to drop, you know, his favorite joint, if you will. Let's go ahead and do LL Cool J's My Radio.
Bump it up.
My radio, believe me, I like it loud. I'm the man with the box that can rock the crowd. Walking down the street to the hardcore beat while my JVC vibrates the concrete. I'm sorry if you can't understand, but I need a radio inside my hand. Don't mean to offend other citizens, but I kick my volume way past 10. My story is rough, my neighborhood is tough, but I still sport gold and I'm out to crush. My name is Cool J, I devastate the show, but I couldn't survive without my radio. Time to rock my neighbors with a heavy bass. I keep the suckers in fear by the look on my face. My radio bad from the boulevard. I'm a hip hop gangster and my name is Tar. Just stimulated by the beat, bust out the rhyme. Get fresh batteries if it won't rewind. Cause I play every day, even on the subway. I would have got a summons, but I ran away. I'm the leader of the show, keeping you on the go. But I know I can't live without my radio.
I mean, he basically kicks in the next verse. Hook was unpresent at this time. One simple word. Right. But it made its impact. It made its impact. Am I wrong? It made its impact. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Let's talk about what it's going up against. DJ Hobo brought a very special song to the table. Off the Mama Said Loud album.
Banging. Banger alert.
Calm down. You don't get to hype up your own record just yet. Relax. Let the host do his thing, and then we talk about why you chose such a record. Relax, DJ Hobo. There's a method to the madness. But I can't deny that both songs are gems. Let's talk about DJ Hobo's pick. Jingling Baby, the remix.
The jiggling baby.
Go ahead, baby.
The jiggling baby.
Go ahead, baby.
Uncle L, future of the funk. Record time recorded, minus off the junk. spread gossip and believe it, they must. But I slam dunk punks and make them fight the dust. A minute is needed to make a phony rony bleed, to put them in a bucket like a chicken feed. Check out the, pick up the litter, not a quit, I'm nice. And I'ma dust you up and dust you up twice. Never heard it's all service, hysterical fan. Fanatics up the Asiatic miracle man. Prominent, dominant, McCoy and I'm real. Another brother's fan, forget how you feel. He's so-so, I got the instinct. They call me Jeopardy Dome, to put your booty in the clink. Clink and answer to a Marley Marl remix single love. Let me see your earrings jingle, love.
The jingling baby.
Go ahead, baby.
The jingling baby.
Go ahead, baby.
The jingling baby.
Go ahead, baby.
The jingling baby.
Go ahead, baby. I chop.
Oof. Damn. Yo, shout out to Mr. September in the building. Yo, he's. He said the LL dropped today. He'd be considered. What did he say? I want to make sure I quote this man correctly. Funny thing is, if LL did drop as a new act, he would be considered sexist today. And I'm like, I think he's right.
He's right.
All the way.
I mean,
you get canceled immediately.
Yeah. He really ain't no worse. He really ain't no worse than all these cats out right now. If you think about it, though, like all the rappers.
No, man.
All the rappers.
I mean, no, he's not. He's not worse, but. LL does have a, I say rapey, stalkerish.
Oh, wait, we didn't say that.
No, not too. That would be considered misogynistic today.
She's only 17, so you don't sleep.
Yeah.
Oh, snap. Okay. We're here to celebrate this, man. We're gonna keep it quick. We're gonna celebrate. We're gonna hit that second pass. My ass.
What's going on, Jules?
It's off the
heavy editing.
All I picture
is all the editing I have to do. That's all I picture. Like,
that's a lyric.
It is. Again. The man is a legend. Like I said, well, let's talk
absolutely legend.
Let's talk about the first battle.
Of course,
two gems, Triple C, DJ Hobo. They brought us my radio, Jingle and Baby remix. Let's start out with Triple C first. Trip, what made you pick that record?
Go ahead, Trip.
That's the record that started off. Without that, he probably would have never been out.
Okay, good point. I love the foundation.
I feel like Trip C just yelled out outside the window to everybody who's hanging out in front of the building.
If there was no radio, there'd be no LL.
And you know, back then is the JVC. Today is we listening to our iPhones.
Plus the crush groove.
Listen, for sure. Let's talk about it, Hobo. You brought a record to the table. Again, a little further down the line in his career. Not too further down, but Jingle and Baby remix produced by Marley Marl. What made you pick that joint?
You already know, man. That song is banger personified. Party starter. Just get the girls moving. Get the things jingling, if you will. You know, I mean, it's a party record, man. It's just a feel-good party record. I was watching everybody in the joint. Everybody was bopping and moving except Triple C because he knew he lost already.
Yo,
but everybody else was dancing and I'm saying, man, that's a certified classic up and down the board. You play that joint in any setting, you will get a response and it will be favorable. And I mean, it's a party starter, party middle tempo razor, I mean groove, everything, man. The video was dope. It was a house party, if you remember. You know that the fire video. I don't know if they have house parties anymore these days, you know. When we were young, the house party was the joint, and that just, I mean, that was the epitome of a house party right there. So
right,
Jingling Baby, man.
Right.
No. He can't go wrong with the classics, though. He can't go.
Yeah. And you got the ladies with the response too.
Uh-oh, Triple C.
Right.
Jingling Baby.
You had your chances. Like I said, let's see what the rest of the gentlemen in the room chat room. You see what it is. Hobo,
I've never seen someone so eager to lose. But okay.
You don't like it when it's happening to you, huh? Huh?
Hey. It's always happening to me. It's always happening.
Dribble C is upset because he finally picked the joint. He's like, I know this is not no filler. And yet it seems like he might have a good battle going here. Like I said, let's talk to everybody in the chat room. Make sure the voting booth goes up in the chat room. Let's talk to everybody in the room here. And if you're in the internet's watching, like I said, make sure you leave a comment in the YouTube section, the comment section. Let's talk about it. Who wants to step up first? Who do you got when we're talking about My Radio versus Jingling Baby Remix?
I see Ike going.
What's up?
Thank you. I'm going to go first since my record was selected. I'm just going to vote for Jingling Baby. And I mean, this was the record that had the goons dancing before it was cool for goons to dance. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
If you were, I guess, old enough or in that era, if you've never been to a house party and this record come on, you've never really been at a party, bro. For me personally, this record has always been one of my favorite LL Cool J records. You know what I mean? And I think just even from the production, whether it's the remix or the original, the instrumental itself gives you a different feeling as you go and you want to listen to the end of the record, even when it breaks down the bridge, all of that shit, man. It's such a fucking dope and phenomenal record. The video and everything.
Right.
Yo, Hobo, man, I'm mad at you today. I hope you lose, bro.
I have a quick question for Ike. If your hope he loses, so you're saying you're picking Radio then?
No, man.
Oh wow! Look at the Mandarin going.
What do you mean? He said he hopes you lose.
Listen, I'm salty. I'm salty because tonight I thought I was gonna win with Jingling Baby. I'm like, yo, I can't lose. I was in the mirror,
we had a salty tonight. I mean, just real quick, we had a salty president once. I'm just saying, you can't be salty and think you won't get away with things. You know what I'm saying? Let you know, it eventually catches up to you.
Damn. You see what he's doing? I can compare you.
Not at all. I'm just bringing the facts to the table. That's all. I just want to make sure. Listen, DJ Love in the middle. Let's talk about some DJ Love. Hey. Yo. Hold on, Playboy.
Hey, yeah. I compared you to 45. Hold on. I wouldn't stand for that.
Malcontent got something to say. Malcontent, what is it, dog?
No, I was just going to, I wanted to jump on, after Ike, because he says something I totally agree with, right? I may be in the minority, but I absolutely love the original Jingling Baby off of, the Walking with the Panther album, right? That joint was dope to me. And of course, when Marley remixed it.
Marley might have did the original too, or no?
No, he didn't do the original.
Oh, he didn't? Okay,
No, I don't know who did it. Probably Bobcat or one of his normal producers that he used. But the original is dope. The original was dope or whatever, but man, that remix was just amazing. It truly is a timeless hip hop party record. Yeah. And I love Radio is too. It's a bona fide classic era, old school era. But I don't even, I mean, I know, Jingling Baby came out, the remix came out like 1990. It seems timeless, man. You know what I mean? It seems timeless. Like nowadays, you can play it. I think it'll still rock crowds like crazy, like even more so than Radio, which we all love. But Jingling Baby's the one.
That bass, man. The bass alone.
Iconic though, man. It made it into the movies.
All right.
He made it into the classic movies.
All right.
That's true.
All right.
Nah,
that's all we had at the time.
But think about it as it being one of the only landscapes for the hip hop music to be shown on such a bigger picture, if you will, and LL was there for that.
True.
His sound was one of the significant sounds that proved like, oh, this is what's going on. This is like what they decided to present as like, this is hip hop at the moment. And he was young. I mean, we're talking about he's a teenager this time, right?
I mean the Radio too, that of course the thing too that really defines both to me too is the fact that Radio was like, I think, 84, 85, I believe, and Jingling Baby is 90, and 85. And so again, like I always mentioned, the times are changing. The beats are being elevated. The rhymes are being elevated. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So hip-hop is hitting that stride in 1990, coming out of the 80s. So that's another reason why, in my opinion, why that record is so big for what it is as far as Jingling Baby is concerned.
Yeah. Fair enough. We got one vote in for aside from the guys who brought the records, and we got Ike putting his vote down. We got Malcontent putting his vote down for Jingling Baby. Is there anybody at this point that wants to place a vote down for My Radio?
Listen, man. I'm gonna have to go with, and I'm still pissed at Hobo because he took my song. That's one of my favorite joints, you know.
It's such a banger, man.
Every so often I play that song. Triple C, I think you lost this round, sir. I'm going.
Yeah, guys, just... you guys don't, you don't, you don't appreciate classics.
Well, listen, let me tell you something, Triple C.
Those are drops. Those were two drops, right?
Yo,
there.
What do you call the art person, like the concierge, the counselor, the curator? Triple C's a curator here at EBR as far as our art, but when it comes to hip hop, here.
Rock the I'm going with Jiggling Baby, man. Sorry.
Fair enough. Listen, yep. It's already one-sided, but regardless, we're gonna get everybody's, you know, vote down. But y'all know how this works. Your shit don't really matter. I'm just letting you know though. We're gonna find out what you think. But like I said, we got only one vote in the room at the moment for my radio, which is brought to us by Triple C. Cool Breeze, Malcontent, Ike Infamous, obviously Hobo going with Jiggling Baby. I mean, what are you thinking here? It's scandalous.
Yeah, that's why I spoke up. That's why I spoke up for Jiggling Baby. That's why I spoke up for Jiggling Baby earlier. Yeah.
Okay, you're placing your vote.
Yeah. You can't really. It's the thing about, and this is again where it gets tough. The DJ bag. If I go to the DJ bag right now, Jiggling Baby is coming out the crate way before radio is. Unfortunately.
Right. Unfortunately.
Right.
It looks like we know.
This ain't about. I was gonna say this ain't so much about like age, because like, sometimes there's like. Like, I personally think, right, so if, like, Run DMC, for instance, right?
Sure.
Like Sucker MCs, like, that beat is so timeless. Like, it's a very old song, but it's so timeless. Yeah, it can beat out a lot of, like, newer stuff.
Sure.
Radio is dope, but it just don't hit, like, the same way as Jingle Baby. Jingle Baby was just, like, another level. Sometimes it's just like that. I mean, it's all LL, though, so, you know, it's all good.
No, I have a question for everybody in the room. I mean, we obviously know who the winner is. I'm going to announce round number one's winner in a second. But I have a question for the people that were actually, I guess, present in time mentally, right? Because, I mean, it's been a while since these records dropped that we can remember when they dropped. Seeing as how, you know, my radio was one of the first hip-hop records to really achieve a status, you know, of real notoriety at the time. Do y'all remember hearing Can't Live Without My Radio on the radio, on mixtape, whatever version you may have heard it first, or the video music box, whatever?
Heard on the streets.
And of course you heard on the streets, Triple C.
I was young.
No, you're polishing your gun. You're on the streets. When you could do that outside. But I mean, and I asked that question because I know it was a little bit more like a happier sound of hip hop at the time, kind of like a ball with a bar kind of version. Then you got LL not introducing, but ushering in this more like, again, let's just call that the street sound of its time. I mean, he's yelling, he's young, he's passionate. Some of these older guys some of these other rappers were a little older. What were your thoughts on LL as Triple C says, the first presentation of him on Can't Live Without My Radio?
I remember watching Crush Groove.
Okay, that was okay.
And then hearing the song and looking at just not LL, but just the other acts within the movie. And that was like somewhat of my introduction to LL through like Crush Groove. Mm. And so that's what I remember. But then I would hear the songs on the radio and stuff like that.
For me, you know, what you said, Jules, is kind of correct, but kind of incorrect too. Oh. I mean, it wasn't such a happy, I mean, because first of all, you gotta realize that Run DMC came out before them, right? And Run DMC before LL, they dropped albums and had big hits before them. I mean, even cats like, you know, like Curtis Blow, they were talking some real stuff. Sugar Hill Gang, I mean, not Sugar Hill, I mean, Grandmaster Flash and Melly Mel, talking some real stuff, you know what I mean? So they had party records, but they also had some very real stuff. So, you know, and then the thing with L is that he was just such like a lyricist. I mean, I know people look at him now as like, you know, the lover boy and all that stuff, and there was that, but he came out just trying to take out MCs. I mean, this dude was like rapping, you know?
Dr. Jekyll, you had a lot of records.
Was he the first like young rapper at that time? Because like I said, when you mentioned Melly Mel, all these people, I know it's back in time, they weren't always old, right? But I mean, they were young, but he was like a teenager.
Like, he was like,
Yeah, even Run DMC, they were probably like 19, you know, they're a little bit older, you know, like college age, whatever. But yeah, he was definitely like a high schooler. And that was like different back then, especially the way he came. He came hardcore coming out at 16.
Well, I think with with my radio because I got introduced, shout out to my uncle, you know what I mean? Like one of the first rap records I ever heard was I'm Bad. You know what I mean? So when you think about my radio, I think LL stayed consistent to what he did early in the 80s. He was always taking hip hop to a different place, to a different point. You know what I mean? Like we spoke before about I Need Love. You know what I mean? Like for that record to come out at that time, for it to be as big as it was, for Jigglin' Baby to drop as a single. And so I think my radio, it's not that it doesn't have that impact. It's just that it's a different groove, a different move. It was still something crazy, like Malcontent was saying. Everybody's talking about real shit. And he's like, I can't live without radio. You know what I mean?
I would also add, too, real quick, Ike, too. It also depends on how you were introduced to the game. So much like how your uncle, hipped you to certain stuff. For me, you know, I have an older brother and an older sister. So that's how I know all those 80s records, because I'm going through their catalog and what they were playing. So that's the reason why, you know, like Tila Rock, well, I think Tila Rock was a little bit later, but like all those early hip hop 80s records, they weren't necessarily, you didn't hear them on the radio. You just kind of had to be in the moment and when those records were out to get them. You know what I mean? So like my sister's collection of 80s hip hop records and actually one of my older cousins who was a DJ now, I took their collections of like 80s hip hop of all those records that came out from back then.
That's fire. That's
so
fire.
So the thing is sometime, I think going touching with LL, I heard that via more so like, you know, being out, you know, in the streets. And then I think I heard it maybe once in a while on the radio, but that was really my introduction to it. It wasn't really like it was a constant rotation because there wasn't, other than Video Music Box and I think Bobby Simmons, there wasn't really huge platforms like that.
The late night mixes on the radio, that's when you would hear it, you know, stuff like that. Or if you're out at like the park playing ball, someone's booming it on their box or something. That's what I would hear. I heard it back then. You know, with that, but before Crush Groove, I would hear his stuff. But yeah.
Let's wrap it up. Like I said, round number one, we're getting ready to wrap it up. We basically took the two records that Triple C and DJ Ho brought to the table, My Can't Live Without My Radio versus Jingling Baby Remix. And we basically had to break it down. It looks like it was a pretty one-sided event, Triple C. I apologize. You had no stance up here, baby. We're looking at Jingling Baby Remix, DJ Ho, his choice up on the board.
Shout out to Kazal, bro.
Shout out to you guys. Listen, if you know, you know. Listen,
I got those singles.
Hold on. DJ Scams. Is G Street Records?
D&D Records, I believe.
Well, D&D later. I heard D&D later. The repertoire joint. Wasn't that like G Street? Am I wrong? What label was that? Was that the repertoire joint with the Jay-Z sample? That was fire too. Shout out to y'all, man.
I'm not sure if it was G Street, but shout out to them, man.
But yeah, no, shout out to, like I said, I want to say.
You did say G Street, yes.
I know my hip hop. Busters let me host because I know. Right? Shout out to Q-Ball Kirkus. Like I said, also, you guys definitely were up in D&D on a regular basis. Again, shout out to the D&D Project all over that.
We know, baby. I love the D&D project.
Yo, shout out to you for the shout out saying you love the show. Like I said, we definitely do for guys like you. You know what I'm saying? Thank you very much. Moving on to round number two. Stick around. Like I said, listen, what you think about this? Let's talk about it. We got two records brought by two gentlemen in the room. We're talking about Ill Bomb, the classic, produced by DJ Scratch, brought to us by Infamous, going up against Jack the Ripper, brought to us by Malcontent. Oh, man. Listen, this is about to get interesting right now. Like I said, we're talking two songs that nobody thought would even, you know, be in the contest tonight, but here we are. It's about to get crazy, man. Let's talk about the first record, Ill Bomb, off that Greatest of All Time.
Chrome shoes paralyzed. Getting money like this, people want my vibe. Full of jealousy and pride. Hate the way I ride. So
Sometimes you speak, sometimes you don't. Figure this nigga souped up, cause he cooped up. Guaranteed to rip shit soon as it's looped up. Your nigga slept before your girl's panties wasn't wet. I'm a star, double addictive, double R. Never struggled hard to lead a bubble scar. Not the car, it's the man. Daddy cool, put it down. No comparing me to y'all. Niggas are circus clowns. L.A. worth paper. Ask Russell Simmons who put him up in that skyscraper. Ask my dog Zephyr Fubu who made a major. LL nigga, now who's next to need a favor? Drop a bomb on him. Remain calm on him. Pierce the nipples, throw the LL charms on him. Keep gangsta shit pumping through my system with my strobe like flash. You can't miss him. Listen.
Oh man, that beat is insane.
Shit is so fire.
That beat is so sick. Shout out to DJ, shout out to Joe Hurdum in the building. It's got to see you again, you know what I mean? Everybody join us at Rabu Bastic. Like I said, everybody join us every Monday night. We shout out to y'all for always joining us.
Appreciate y'all.
Yeah, salute.
Record number one out of round number two. Like I said, Ike Infamous brought us Ill Bomb, produced by the Scratch. Like I said, we're going to move on to Malcontent's Choice. Let's talk about the record he brought to the table. Another classic. Let's talk about that LL Cool J, Jack the Ripper.
Milky, and I'm back. My ace in the hole with this brand new track. I'ma slow it up and speed it up, and now you're gonna eat it up. Listen to the funky beat, my tongue is gonna beat it up. I did it, but the devil didn't make me. I did it for the suckers who tried to shake and fake me. Proving the point that I'm the serious joint. And you can roll me up and pump me, and then I'll anoint your head with oil. Lots of oil, it makes you run like water. Watch to boil, cause I made them play it. Made them say it, made them okay it. Made them obey it. Prince of the dollars on the prowl. How you like me now, punk? You'll live the foul. Here's what my game is, killing's what my aim is. A washed up rapper needs a wash up. My name is
I forgot.
Wow.
I even had to mouth it out. Like, I forgot to join this.
That's big production. That's big production right there, man. That's big production right there, dude.
You know what's wild about that joint? You know that little that bass line at the very beginning? That joint goes through the whole song like that. It's weird. That thump goes through the whole song just like that. That's crazy. But yeah,
Does anybody know who produced Jack the Ripper? Because I need to know.
I don't know.
I think he did.
You think so?
I think I heard him.
Probably Battle Cat, but I don't know. I don't know. I'm just guessing.
Battle Cat or Cuckoo. No,
he was on his radio station saying that he produced a lot of stuff himself.
Yeah, I've heard him
say that.
I mean, that would have been an easy one to produce, because that's a sample. It's a straight sample of what's the song? You know the song, Scan. Roach Clip. Ashley's Roach Clip. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that, okay. that got used so much. Run DMC all, and they use that like crazy.
Everybody used that.
Yeah, they used all different parts of the song too. But yeah, that was dope, man. He killed it on that. And just the fact that it was a diff record, man.
Yeah.
Let me shut up.
It says here when I go to Genius, shout out to Genius, it says Rick Rubin produced the record. So, I mean, yeah, it's possible. I mean, it could be wrong, but I mean, I think they might be right. Whatever. But I mean, they are claiming that Rick Rubin produced a record. Again, a jam in its own. But let's talk about it. Both records got played. We know what's going on. Let's talk to the gentleman that brought the records into the room. Let's start with man Ike Infamous, Sir Ill Bomb. Again, I think you caught a lot of flack in the beginning. You know, Ill Bomb, oh, I can't believe you brought Ill Bomb, right? Am I on the same page as you? Or are you going to accuse me of being on the opposite side when I'm trying to agree with you?
No. You sound correct, sir.
Just checking the pulse. So, with that being said, I mean, I think the vibe kind of turned a little differently when that joint got rained out a little bit. I think everybody was kind of caught up in the mix. I mean, the chat room was lit for a minute, talking about this sound goes forever and all this, that, the other. Why did you bring that record to the table?
Well, it absolutely does. But I brought this record. This was like my third record that I was going to bring to the battle, because the record I wanted to bring was brought to you by DJ Hobo with Jigglin' Baby. So I had to then figure out something.
You could say that You're supposed to, because I chose it last time. So you can say that.
No. Oh, wow. This was the first time Trip C caught me in my fucking foot. Like, boom. Oh, shit.
It's Spider-Man. Talking about? Yeah, oh, shit.
Now, with Ill Bomb, though, like, as in comparison to Jigglin' Baby, I think Ill Bomb did exactly what Jigglin' Baby did at that time, that LL Cool J dropped it. It was the production for him at that time to get on something like that was crazy. Was like, yo, damn, LL got a fucking gem. You know what I'm saying? And then regardless, like you saw here in the chat room, no matter where you're at, that's a record. You put that on, you drop that needle, it's guaranteed to get a response, no matter where you're at, with the goons, with the ladies, period. You know what I mean? So
it's true. And
one of the flyest fucking hooks LL Cool J did, like, you know what I mean? Put the LL charms on him. You know what I'm saying? Like, that shit.
I mean, Project Elevator brings up another good point about that record. The scratching is.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. Shout out to DJ Scratch, man.
Yep. And if in that record, but listen, dope joint. Dope song altogether. Like I said, shout out to you. We even had numerous conversations about this record on other episodes because that record has come up before in conversation. Mm-hmm. So like right. I said, you can check that out in previous episodes. But we literally talk about how crazy it is that he picked that particular portion of the record when there's so many other dope portions of that record. So shout out to DJ Scratch. Let's talk about the Rick Rubin produced Jack the Ripper. Your man Malcontent bringing that to the table. What made you pick this record, Mal?
Well, it's always been like a favorite of mine, man. It's like, I mean, first of all, you know, there was all the hype around it. It was a diss record, obviously. You know, he was going at Modi, and you know, it was like a lot of hype behind it, man. It was just like, man, this is crazy. And it was in between like his albums when they dropped, so it just kind of came out of nowhere. I remember when I first heard it, you know, listening to, you know, all the like the late night hip hop mixes wherever I was living at the time, and I was like, yo, this song is crazy. I'm like, he just went all off on dude. I'm like, this is gonna be a hell of a battle, you know what I mean? So it was like, it was hyped up with that. And then I remember, like, over the years, you know, like especially when it first came out, I started like really learning the lyrics. Man, that dude was just he was spitting fire that whole time, man. I mean, he was, granted, it's old school, so there's a lot of like the yelling and the growling and stuff, but it is dope.
Now, how old was he when he dropped that record, you think?
Oh, that one, he was like probably like 19, 20, I'm assuming, somewhere around there, right? Yeah, that was definitely teenager. It was in between Bigger and Deffer and Walking with a Panther. So I know in Bigger and Deffer, he was like 18 to 19.
Okay.
So somewhere around there, you know? But the thing about it is like, and like he had like lyric, like one of the lyrics on that, I don't know if people even caught it. He was like, I think he said something about, check out the way I say mine, display mine, fame mine. He said, I'm J on the back behind the cool without the AY. I mean, you know, because people saw J spelled J like J-A-Y, but he didn't spell the J-A-Y. I mean, he was just saying like the lyrics in that joint, he was just like killing it. And I was just kind of like, yo, this dude, this is like another level song. So I like learned that whole song, every lyric. And I just loved like the beats bananas. I just think it's just like, it just got like that energy to it. And the fact, you know, this records back then, I mean, obviously it was the whole Roxanne saga and, you know, a song Peppa did with, you know, with Dougie Fresh and all that and, you know, Slick Rick. But I mean, this is like a battle come. You knew these were like two MCs, you know, you know, you got the one young legend going against the actual old legend, you know? So it was just a real exciting time. But, you know, but, and again, yo, Ike, no disrespect. I absolutely love Ill Bomb. It's a dope song. So, you know, no disrespect, whatever happens, man, this is dope. But I just had to like, you know, rep for Jack the Ripper because I absolutely love that song. Always, still to this day, I love that song.
Yeah, absolutely.
Mr. Mal, forget about that no disrespect. So we're trying to get the ratings up.
Fuck Ill Bomb, man. That shit's whack, right? Son. Say nothing in that shit. It's a dope beat, man.
We're trying to get the ratings up. No speech.
I could have rapped over that joint. It would have been the hottest
if,
shit.
If this is coming from HR, oh, wow. Oh, shit.
Wow.
Yo, man. Look, yo, LL was spitting some shit about shit, man.
I'm joking, man. No, I love that shit. That shit's dope, man. But it's a good battle. It's a good battle.
Yo, Cool B, ain't you the head of HR, Breeze?
I'm on vacation.
Oh, you on vacation today? Gotcha.
Oh, so
he's the head of instigating today. That's what he is.
You know what that is? And nah, when we're at the bar, I'm not HR. We're not at the job. Like, oh, okay.
Cat's got you on tape.
You know my laptop was on. The Zoom
Project,
is still on.
Project Veritas. Project Veritas ass out this bitch.
Listen, let's talk. We heard from both guys that brought the records into the room. Again, we're talking Ill Bomb going up against Jack the Ripper. Two different points in time, two different sounds. Let's talk about LL Cool J's best records of all time. Who do you got? Who's stepping up first? We got the booty moves in the room already. They're already doing their thing. Who's stepping up first in here?
Oh, man.
Come on. Man, somebody jump.
Well, here's what I'm going to say, man. Listening to those two songs again is just like, just kind of brought it back because I haven't heard those songs in a minute, especially like Jack the Ripper. Or Jack the Rapper, is it? Or Ripper?
Jack the Ripper.
Ripper. I said it right. So, but the thing is that, I'm going to slight edge Ill Bomb because it was that beat on that Ill Bomb, was it just knocked a little harder than that Jack the Ripper, man. But listening to the Jack the Ripper song, and Mal was pointing certain things out. L was going at Mo D hard on that record, man. Pause.
Yeah, I'm torn with these choices. So
this was, I thought it was going to be an easier round, but like slight edge, man. And I mean slight.
Yeah, this one is tough.
This one's
I was like, that slight ain't good enough. And you just heard my voice.
Listen, I don't mean to mess up your machine, Jules. I'm sorry, but.
Hey, whoa. Yeah, oh,
thank you. Thank you. Thank you. It's starting to come out. The truth, let it be told. You know what I'm saying? It's great.
Accusations. There's too much Donald Trump in your newspapers lately in front of you. I'm not throwing me in the mix, but I'm always coming up with something. You know what I'm saying? You got to calm down. Let's talk about it. We got the first vote in the room. Cool Breeze putting it down for Ill Bomb. Who do you got? Ike Infamous.
It's my record.
No, I got.
Take that part out. We're gonna take that part out.
It's starting.
Jules,
see right now that time.
Jules wanted to feed me to the lions so bad.
I did. I was like, it didn't work. It totally backfired. Right? That's why it's out of here.
So Jules had an LL stance.
I was trying to do my LL. Yeah.
You should have just voted, man. It would have been like two votes for you.
He wouldn't have caught it. Yeah, you're right.
Half on, half off. Two votes.
Yeah, I'll go next. You know, although I like Jack the Ripper, but, you know, I got to go with the Ill Bomb because I got to see it go through because he didn't go through last time.
Chestnut checkers. Gentlemen.
Joe Hurdum got an Ill breakdown for it. So he basically says, Jack the Ripper, all-time class record, but Ill Bomb with that beat is a flow forever. And
I could agree.
I think that kind of sums up what, you know.
Yeah, I vote for Ill Bomb, too. I vote for Ill Bomb.
Yeah, I got a feeling in the room is kind of falling in that direction. We basically got three votes in. Let's see what this last one is. What are you thinking, Hobo?
I mean, I was, you know what? I don't usually want my vote to not count, but I'm glad it doesn't in this situation. Because I don't really know what I'm going to choose because that Ill Bomb beat is so dope. And I know we didn't give it a lot of love, or maybe it went up against one of my records and that's why Triple C lost.
Oh, wow.
I think you're right.
I mean, I'm not quite sure.
Make it right.
But that beat is dope, man. And Project Elevate, I think, brought up a good point. And you know, and I'm not gonna say he who shall not be mentioned, but for that song to be on a mixtape, in that environment, and LL was not really, you know, LL wasn't on mixtapes at that point.
There's no need. He's the god MC.
He wasn't on no mixtapes like that at that point. He wasn't on.
He never had to be on the mix. He said the blueprint.
Yeah, he didn't need it.
I mean, you're right. He didn't need it, but I'm not saying he needed it. But my point is, he wasn't on it. He wasn't he wasn't doing that circuit.
And then, but let's be clear, the mixtape we're talking about by DJ Funk Master
Flex.
No,
we're not listen,
it's okay, it's okay because in the edit, all you guys can't see is all you're gonna see is me just smiling.
That's why I'm talking over what you're saying so it don't go on there. We're not talking about that.
Let's be clear. Rest in peace, Big Cap. The album by DJ Funkmaster Flex and Big Cap. You gotta throw in the Big Cap so you can save the conversation. And then be clear. That was an album. It was an album, but it was a mixtape album.
You get too excited over that. You need to get at all.
This is the Herman episode.
I can recognize who the people I learned from off the radio. And Funkmaster Flex was definitely someone I paid attention to growing up. Absolutely. Now, later on, we had that conversation. He got ridiculous.
Jules, Hobo said, "Stop right there, sir." He caught you right in your tracks.
He did. Like I was trying to vote or something.
This is the Pee Wee Herman episode where Funkmaster Flex's name is the word of the day, and everybody makes noise when he's saying it.
Funkmaster Flex.
Right. But back to my point. In all seriousness, for LL to have to put this type of beat out and this type of song out in that environment, and I don't remember the album, but I would venture to say that's probably one of the better songs on the album. With that said, I'm gonna go with Ill Bomb. But I love Jack the Ripper. I love the diss. I love the fact that LL really he really set it on Kumo D. Like,
went in
repeatedly.
He said it. He said he that. Crush Hammer Mo D. And Ice-T.
Hammer and Ice-T.
He did that though.
He crossed all three of them on one song on Break of Dawn, which is a banger in itself.
It's another joint.
So I mean, I would say that the beef between them two, I don't know if Kumo D ever really had anything to like really come at LL like. I know he has some songs or whatever, but I don't know if anything like really hit as hard as the way LL hit at him. So
transition, because remember Mo D is coming out of that late 70s, early 80s. Yeah. You know what I mean? So that was another thing too. See, that's why I always reference the timelines and everything because they play a critical point.
Absolutely.
When everything begins to change and shift while doing this, you know. So I mean, for Mo D, I think the last big record, his big record, I think was like Wild Wild West was like 86, I think, or 87.
I think it was 87.
And then I Go to Work, which was like the 90s, but by that point, he was already
being that was a good song, out
at that point.
No, I Go to Work. Yeah,
I got a question. Does he have a newer song out now? I could have sworn he came up with a newer song.
I hope not. Why are we saying hope not, man? If the dude can keep a rhythm, better than a Sexy Red or a Blueface, why the fuck not?
That's a good point, brother.
Blueface versus Kumo D? Is that the battle?
Let's not forget. We gotta allow our rappers to age. So it's like the rock stars, you know, they're still performing.
But here's the thing too.
True. Good point, Trip.
That he did a song with Redman. Do you remember that song?
Kumo D?
Kumo D.
I don't know.
Kumo D did a song with Redman, sir. And there's a video for it as well, too.
What's the name of it?
Don't remember. I'll look it up right now.
That's crazy. You got me with that one.
I don't know that at all. I don't know that one either.
Let's go ahead and wrap things up. We still got to get a few more rounds of going, like I said. And wrapping up round number two. Again, we're talking LL Cool J all night. You got Ill Bomb brought to us by your man Ike Infamous. Jack the Ripper brought to us by your man Malcontent. And while there was a lot to say about both records, it ended up being a one-sided affair. Illbomb taking the win for this round. Round number two goes to Illbomb. It's going down. Like I said, every Monday night, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, right here, live, EBR. Like I said, who do you got? Follow us everywhere. Eats, Beats, and Rhymes, one word. Audio podcast needs YouTube, Twitch. Please follow us, leave comments. Shout out to everybody in the chat room as always. I want to give a shout out to, no, maybe this is September. I think he mentioned it earlier on. I didn't get a chance to say it. He said mad people forgot to bring up Backseat of My Jeep because they said mad people used to sample that exact record like over and over.
Yeah. Oh, yes. No. I think that was going to be an honorable banger, mention. Bro. Yeah.
That's just how you want to play the hand.
Yeah, exactly. Because that's it. That's almost like radio. You know what I mean? Like it's almost in that realm of radio. You know what I'm saying? Like it's such a dope song. It's a different, like we all know what it is, man. You know what I mean? Like
that man said he lit a candle and put it on the dashboard.
He said,
How you not burn it?
Glass? He said, don't get shy. Here's a little for your eye.
It hornier.
So relaxing.
He said, your tools on the roof. That man was spitting, boy.
That's my record, though.
That's so many hits, man. We didn't talk about it. I mean, maybe we could play it later. But
yeah, later.
I mean, going back to Cali, dog.
Wait, we'll talk about all the records in a second. Let's wrap up round number three. But again, we're celebrating the guy all evening, so we're definitely going to talk about more of these records later on tonight. We'll find out what everybody's other choices were, and I'm sure there's a bunch of gems in there as well. Let's talk about round number three. Last of the three, let's talk about it. Rock the Bells, the track, the tour, the festival, all in one. The classic brought to your man right here, Cool Breeze, brought to us by him. Going up against I'm Bad, brought to you by your man DJ Scandalous, another classic, again, from the back in the day. Are those both from the same album or no? No, right?
No, one's from the first, one's from the second.
No. Yes, he's absolutely right.
Rock the Bells from the first.
Yep, you're absolutely right. Rock the Bells off that first radio album. Let's talk about it. Here you go.
LL Cool J is hard as hell. Battle anybody, I don't care. You do. I excel. They all fail. Gonna go tell double L must rock the bells. I've been waiting and debating for oh so long. Still starving like Marvin for a Cool J song. If you cried, I thought I died. You definitely was wrong. It took a long time.
Mr. Summer's pushing it. He wants us to do the WAP. I'm like, you wildin'.
WAP to that song. Yeah, I do the WAP to that song.
Not doing the WAP.
Rhyming and designing with your girl on my lap.
And if LL said it, it got to be true. So I'm just
LL was the original Mr. Steal Your Girl.
This is what I'm saying.
A thousand percent.
If he couldn't do it, who else could? At that time, we're talking about.
He's that type of guy.
And he figured out in every era. He figured out in every era how to get him.
Let's talk about it. Like I said, that classic had to go up against another classic. We're talking about I'm Bad.
His face in the sand, not the last mafioso, I'm a MC cop, make it say go LL and do the WAP. If you think you cannot rock me, yeah boy I bet, cause I ain't met a motherfucker who can do that yet. Trendsetter, I'm better, my rhymes are good, I got a gold name plate, that says I wish you would. And when I begin then, I gotta join in and before my rhyme is over, you know I'ma win. Cool chance to rock, so you better make way. Ask anybody in the crowd, they say the kid don't play. I don't wear disguise because I'm dull over my. Got a pinpoint rap that makes you feel trapped. So many girls on my dock, I threw my phone in tap. I'm bad. Cool J.
icing. I'm a soldier at war.
I'm not gonna lie, y'all got a tough one right now because both these
you
joints
are not kidding, super man.
I'm not even. I don't even want to get accused of no manner. I'm gonna shut up now. I'm gonna let you decide. You got what? I don't want to be accused of shit. The voting booth is up. Make sure you vote. Everybody in the room right now. Let's get to it because we still got to find out which is the weakest of the three, unfortunately. But right now, we're trying to figure out who is the strongest: Rock the Bells or I'm Bad. Who do you got?
We got to talk to the dudes first, man, while they put the joints up.
You can go, Breeze, if you want. You can go.
I was hoping y'all would kill me. I thought you would know by now it's your turn. Okay, let me get your attention again. Let's talk to the gentleman that brought the records to the table. Okay, let me get the last two rounds.
That's right. You got to count. You got to stay.
Cool Breeze was also like, I ain't stepping out to that motherfucker say my shit correctly.
I know you're a little nervous, Jules, but you don't got to vote. It's okay.
Cool Breeze, who do you got? Why did you bring this record to the table? What is it about Rock the Bells?
I brought this record to the table because Jingling Baby was taken by Hobo, but it's okay. We're not going to go down that avenue again. But this song, for me, outside of Jingling Baby, which Hobo took, but we're not going to go into that. So for this song, for me, I would just say that everything that he has built up is named off of Rock the Bells, not just the song, but I would say the podcast, I would say
radio show.
Radio show that he has on Sirius. His website is rockthebells.com. And he has the Rock the Festival. And I think he did a Rock the Bells tour, I think. And if
that's
not
also correct.
Yeah, so if not, he will do another one. Those things can kind of go on, and there's no shelf life for it. And the song itself is just a dope song with the drums and the background, and it sounds like it has a little Caribbean feel to it as well too. And the raps are just on point, man. I mean, you can't deny that song. Throw it on, it's gonna move you, it's gonna give you a feeling, it's gonna make you dance, it's gonna make you wanna rap, it's gonna make you wanna do anything you wanna do in this world and conquer whatever it is that you wanna conquer. It's competition.
Damn, Tony Robbins, you talking motivation and shit?
He's using the source words.
Rock the Bells, motivational tour, coming to you.
Breeze, I'm gonna let you finish.
Yeah.
The Hobo know what I'm about to say. Before you finish, just recognize that beat is go-go. It's not Caribbean.
I was waiting.
But here's the thing. When you have the go-go, the drums and the bass, because you have drum and bass, and you have it's another instrument that I'm thinking of, I can't even think of right now.
The 808?
The 808 bass? No, not 808. Like the steel drum. Steel drum sound. All of that is kind of like Caribbean enthused, it has that fusion in it. So
yeah, you're right with the steel drum.
So everything can kind of go back to Caribbean or African as well too. So I would say
true.
The Triple C. Triple C wins.
That's junk yard, man. But okay. All right.
But I'll go with go-go.
That's right, Malcolm. Talk that shit.
No, I would say go-go. That's right. The go-go sound in the music. So, yes. I would say go-go.
I just want people to respect it. This classic.
Was this an assistance to Breeze right now? Can I go
to Fred?
I'm sorry, Stan.
I didn't win this.
You see how the game is. I'm glad everybody gets a taste to see how the game is rigged,
man. Let's
see what you made these scandals. I'm saying these scandals were on bad to the table scan.
Yeah.
You could sum it up kind of quickly. You know, we're running short on time. If you could let us know what is.
All right, I'll try to make this real quick. So Rock the Bells, great record. Love the record. A lot of good points made. The difference between Rock the Bells and I'm Bad, for one, is that for me, the production is more exciting on I'm Bad because it has the SWAT sample, right? Which if SWAT was a popular TV show. And as Mr. September brought up, it also has the Courageous Cat and Danger Mouse. beat sample in the record. So for the music and the composition of the record alone, I think is better, number one. Number two, the lyrics were definitely, to me, more brass. And he was spitting, in my opinion, way harder on I'm Bad, talking greasier on I'm Bad than he was on Rock the Bells again, in my opinion. Let me add on to two. My man said, forget Oreo, eat Cool J cookies. My man said, I will crush you into a jelly bean. His lyrics were, his points and punchlines to me on I'm Bad were just way more sharper, in my opinion. Three, the video for I'm Bad, with the whole scenario of the chase about the song. And then four, which is my DJ bag, right? It's because I'm Bad was just like Rock the Bells, was just one of those records that was used in the DMCs and the New Music Seminars. It was the record, it was one of the records of choice when you were competing as a battle DJ during that time. So from that reason, right? I'm choosing that record. Although Rock the Bells may have the iconic status, but I think the overall production, value, lyrics, and everything is way better than Rock the Bells, in my opinion.
I think you don't really mean that, but okay. Jelly Bean?
Your song's Jelly Bean, what?
I'm just glad to know that DJ Scanlan's version of "I'm Gonna Keep It Quick" includes four fucking bullet points.
That's the short one.
I just want everyone to pay attention. Scan had some real passion in his voice when he was talking about this.
Yo, it sounded like his voice cracked a little bit. Like he went on.
Nah, man. Wow.
Wow.
Listen, cool breeze. I got a call. Like that's a false call right there. Now with that super duper mic that this motherfucker's talking into lately, that makes him sound like Barry White. I have to. The only thing cracking is the bass in the room. That's it. and it's the truth. You know what I mean? It sounds like Frankie Crockett and the Quiet Storm. You know what I'm saying? Like after dark. But let's talk about it. Let's get right down to it. You heard both gentlemen in the room. Like I said, we're cutting short on time. We still have to move on to the next round. Let's talk about it kind of quickly here. We see what the voting booth is. We're going to find out the results for all three rounds in the next round here. Let's talk about it. Rock the Bells versus I'm Bad. Who's going first? Who do you got? Malcolm said.
All right, since I was talking all that stuff. So look, one thing I will say, you know, Scam makes a good point about like how, you know, it was more like the energy in I'm Bad, right? But the lyrics, I mean, this fool came out and said, I'm not a virgin, so I know I'll make Madonna scream. You hated Michael and Prince ever, all the way ever. I mean, this dude said this back in 1985, when they were like the biggest artists ever. This dude was talking greasy as a teenager to the top artists. Everybody knows, everybody from the 80s knows how big those artists were. Completely different genre. He set himself apart from all the other rappers doing that. And Rock the Bells, I just love the 808 bass to it. I love the go-go sample. I just think it just has crazy energy. I love both songs, but I'm gonna give the edge to Rock the Bells. It's just so much more of a classic. And I think, you know, you can play it nowadays anywhere and it'll rock the party. I think the DJ bag skews towards Rock the Bells, in my opinion, Scan. All respect.
Spoken as the record he spoke for, so that phone a friend definitely worked. I feel you, Malcolm. The phone a friend worked. I got you.
I'm talking about at parties. I'm talking about the DJ conferences. You're right. The DJ battles, that's different. But Rock the Bells for me, for a party.
Anybody else want to step up and put their vote down?
Yeah, I'll go. Yeah, I'm choosing I'm Bad, because I'm Bad was so bad that they put in the Michael Jordan, The Last Dance joint documentary.
Okay.
Oh, that was hot right there when he did that.
With all the montage. Okay, I see what you're talking about. I mean, listen, Triple C's got his reasons.
Right.
At the moment, DJ Hobo, are you putting your vote down? What's that?
I always give a nod to Go-Go because Go-Go is the shit. So shout to Trouble Funk on the sample. However, for me, and I know it's not part of it is part of the song, but it's more so part of the video, I think. But the part where he's like, give me that walkie-talkie. my hat is like a Sharks fan, and that's iconic, man, when he did that.
Right.
I gotta go if I'm bad.
And Adam getting another vote from DJ Hobo in the room. Does anybody else want to step their vote up? Ike, is that you?
Yeah, man. So besides Slick Rick's children's story, LL Cool J's I'm Bad was the first two records I was introduced from my uncle to hip hop. You know what I mean? As far as like this, and it was, I was set off from there. So not only due to the love factor from my uncle and everything like that, the family, it goes to I'm Bad. But when you listen to the record, to think about like Rock the Bells and then you hear I'm Bad, you hear how similar it is, but like Scan said, there is something a little bit more tighter, a little bit more direct with I'm Bad that gives you that, it gives you that whole fucking, gives you that walk and talk feel, but you still get a little bit of that vibe from Rock the Bells in that record, I'm Bad. You know what I mean? So I just think that it's such a phenomenal way that it's done. So I have to go with I'm Bad. And plus, that was going to be the second record I chose because, you know what I mean? My first record with that fucking, this guy, DJ Hobo, you took my shit, man. Fucking Jiggling Baby.
Jiggling Baby? The one?
Yeah, Hobo? Jiggling Baby. Yeah, the one that Hobo took. That guy.
That one.
So, Rain, you guys going to pick Jiggling Baby? So, Rain, you guys going to pick Jiggling Baby before Hobo
did? Yes! My favorite joint.
Yo, Jiggling Baby,
bro. Round number three, we're wrapping it up. It looks like this was probably one of the toughest rounds that we had to deal with tonight because it got last decision. Ike breaking the tie that was actually going on at the moment because it was that thin of a decision. But when we broke down to it, yeah, you know, you're right. My math is wrong now. I'm just high. I'm trying.
Hobo went with I'm Bad too.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, he went against the Go-Go. Yes, he did.
I didn't want to bring it
up. Rocking
the Bells. We decided to put Rock the Bells versus I'm Bad. It looked like it was a pretty heavily decided decision, but it got broken down to a certain amount of numbers, 4-2. I'm Bad taking the win on this particular round, making the following records.
Again, good one.
We're moving on. We call the finals, the semifinals, correct? We need to now tell you which records are moving on. Shout out to LL Cool J. Obviously, this whole thing is about him tonight, giving him his flowers. Rock the Bells Festival went down amazingly. So we had to talk about the best LL Cool J records of all time. Round number one came out with the winner of Jiggling Baby Remix going against My Radio. I Can't Live Without My Radio. Ill Bomb going against Jack the Ripper, taking the win on that round, number two. Round number three, Rock the Bells versus I'm Bad, but I'm Bad taking the win in that round. So the following records are moving on to the final pre-round. Jiggling Baby Remix, Ill Bomb, and I'm Bad. One of these records is not going to make it to the finals. Welcome to round number four, where we talk about which of these records is the weakest of the three. It hurts my heart to say it because we loved all of these records on the way in here, but unfortunately, you ain't coming inside. Nate, you ain't gonna smell. You just got at the door, unfortunately. But how cool you thought you was, you just got stopped at the door and they picked the two behind you. So let's talk about it real quick. The choices brought to us as far as the winning rounds was Jiggling Baby Remix brought by DJ Hobo, Ill Bomb brought to us by Ike Infamous, and I'm Bad by DJ Scandalous. So let's talk about it. Which of these records is not moving on? Which one of you guys, since you guys were the winners, actually wants to maybe go first and make their choice? Which is the weakest of the three?
I will yield to my brothers.
All right, I'm gonna see you later, man. Peace. I'm gonna give you a call later on. All right.
Oh, that's what we're doing. What? So yeah, how about this? I think. I'm going to vote for Jiggling Baby to go because...
That's a lot of hate.
Because... Wait. Hold on a second. It has nothing to do with hate, man. I just told you how much I was attached to that record, I'm Bad, right? And Jiggling Baby is one of my personal favorites, right? I'm Bad is that record. Shout out to my Uncle Al. That's my dude, man. And like, I can't go against my big uncle. You know what I'm saying? But then at the same time, I believe so much in my record, I don't want to go against Jiggling Baby in the finals. I feel like I can beat I'm Bad. So
You know what I mean?
Oh,
you got to think strategic, right?
Oh,
chess, not checkers.
It's chess, not checkers. Thank you very much.
Okay,
thank you very much, Cool Breeze.
We're playing billiards.
In the spirit of competition, then, I am voting for Ill Bomb. You got to get up out of here.
Wow.
See, this is when I have to stay. I'm going to have to just take this shit personal. Now we get personal.
let's wrap it up. We still have to go to the next round.
I think I'm going to change my vote. Can I change my vote? I'm going to change my vote. Can I change my vote?
I mean,
I see what you're about to do.
You know what? You know what? Nah, go ahead. Let everybody finish. I'm sorry. Maybe I'm jumping the gun. Go ahead.
He's about to be strategic.
He had a thought. He's waiting to see the other chest.
Yo, you can't wait to the end and change your vote. Everyone's voting. I'm not gonna let that go.
You're not gonna let that slide.
I'm not gonna let that slide.
And you know, Hobo holds grudges, man. He can bring his like 6 months ago. You know how he does.
I mean, let's talk about it. Do you want to move your vote around, Scam? What's going on?
Let me see. I tell you what. I'm gonna let the people. I'm gonna let my record prevail naturally, baby. All natural.
Talk that shit, Scam.
Listen, it's going down. We got two votes in for Ill Bomb to get out of here. One vote. Jingling Baby, who has to put their votes down? Let's go.
Yeah, sorry, Hobo. Jingling Baby gotta go.
Wow, 2-2. It is. So let's keep it. Now, what are you thinking?
Trips Revenge.
This is actually funny.
Now, what do you got?
Because Hobo been cocky the whole night, man. This is actually funny.
This is hilarious, actually.
but I'm not that type of person, so I'll go ahead and say Ill Bomb.
Ill Bomb getting the ooh snap!
Oh man, look at him up!
I'm about to get my bandana right now. I'm about to ride on you.
Just to finish this up, just to get everybody's choice. Cool Breeze, what are you thinking?
Hey man, you see, if I pick Jiggling Baby, that'll be three, and that'll be a tie with Ill Bomb.
Yeah. That also, I think in this particular case, I believe that should make the winner the obvious in that particular case. Mm. I don't think there's a need to go get like a break, you know, tiebreaker for that one. It's like, well, then we know who's the winner here.
Listen, if I pick Ill Bomb, that's out of here. And well, it's already out of here.
You're basically deciding if the game ends here or if we're gonna go one more round.
That's true.
That's a lot of responsibility.
To
add pressure to it, yo, we're running out of time.
Saw him wipe that bead of sweat off his head.
If I pick Jiggling Baby, then I'm bad wins, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm bad and beat me in that round.
Because I'm bad.
We don't have that much time, but I'm going to let the show go on. Sorry, Ike. I'm going to have to go with Ill Bomb. I'm going to cross that one out. So the show is going on for one more round.
Allow me to introduce Machiavelli.
Just, you know,
Come with me.
You got the mom personally.
Are you all right?
I'm about to start seeing in Alabama.
I'll swim to the docks. About that life.
Hold on a second. Let me go check and make sure my front door is locked.
Listen, We already know. We know who the finalists are for tonight. Let's talk about it. We got DJ Hobo's Choice of Jiggling Baby Remix going up against the classic I'm Bad, brought by DJ Scandalous. Let's get down to it. Let's talk to both gentlemen. Which version of the record, or do you want me to play at this point? How do you want to present said record? Let's start with DJ Hobo's Jiggling Baby. What are we doing here, brother?
I mean, you can just run a second. You can run a second verse. I don't have a specific point to get to. You can run a second verse. That's cool.
Fair enough. Let's see if I can find it.
When you first walked in, I ain't know what to think. Cause you grabbed the microphone like your booty don't stink. And tried to run down back. I can't get over that garbage you were singing. Crawl out of battle, round, round. How you gonna go against an army with a handgun? I'm LL, you don't understand, son. I'm a legend, on top of that I'm living. Now you look booty like the bum is giving. Whoever keeps you up, nah, I said I say it. Whoever set you up, think just out of playing. Cause man, yeah, I feel for you, brother, I'm a bad. 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 Taking out suckers while the ladies pucker. Rolling over punks like a redneck trucker. Innovating, devastating, they don't want a single now. Let me see your earrings jingle.
You're jingling, baby.
Go ahead, baby.
You're jingling, baby.
Go ahead, baby.
You're jingling, baby.
Go ahead, baby.
You're jingling, baby.
Go ahead, baby. Break down.
You know how it breaks down the ending. It's Woo. Dope. That was fire. That was a good place to take that. I like that. Verse number two to the bridge.
Got the breakdown.
Yeah, got the breakdown. I like that.
Don't forget, right? In the breakdown, that's when LL was dancing with the hot ass leather on the leather bucket.
Just for that, the record should lose. Just for that. Just because you were dancing with a hot leather. You should lose.
In the house?
The legend and leather.
You showed up to the house party in the hot leather ass suit?
Yo, Scared, you stupid.
Listen, it is Scandalous. You know what time it is. It's time to bring your records back to play.
No,
what,
doubt. No doubt. Give me second verse also.
A shame, cause I eat rappers like a cannibal, they call me insane. I'm as strong as a bull, of course you know I am poor. I enjoy what I'm doing, plus I'm paid in full. Not fucking Rubin type, but bust it out as I say the kind of rhymes that make MCs wish that I die. Never retire or put my mic on the shelf. The baddest rapper in the history of rap itself. Not bitter or mad, just proving I'm bad. You want a hit, give me an hour, plus a pen and a bag. MCs retreat, cause they know I can beat them and eat them in a battle and the ref won't cheat them. I'm the fast, taking out all rookies. Don't forget Oreos, eat Cool J cookies. I'm bad.
Might end up in a tie, bro.
Oh, man.
We're ready for the time. We're pushing the time. You see what time it is. We got to get ready to wrap it up. Let's talk about it, man. Everybody in the room knows what time it is. Both gentlemen, we heard your speeches earlier, and I think we got to go over them again. Let's talk about it. I'm saying Jiggling Baby Remix going against I'm Bad. Obviously, one vote already in the room for each record, people that brought them in. Who do you got? Everybody else? Let me know.
I'll try to step up first, man. But I just want to say, like, I think it's so crazy on how many singles this man has and how many dope hits he has. And we're talking about two records from back in the late 80s, you know what I mean? That's withstood the test of time. And it's not even like it's a slight or shitting on all of the other records, bro. But just even listening to these two records now, this is a tough fucking round, man. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It really is, because like the presentation by I'm Bad is so fucking crazy, but where Jigglin' Baby takes you in just in hip hop and the party sense and all of that shit is just fucking wild, man. This is a difficult ass round, bro. I don't know, man. Yeah. Both of them. I'm gonna have to say Cool Breeze, bro. Both of them.
Hey, both, no. We haven't heard that in a minute. Both of them.
Right?
But you can't. So who do you got?
Jules, that's the time.
Dan, this sucks because you don't want to feel like you're shitting on the other record if you choose the other
one. Not at all. Keep in mind, we gave flowers the whole way here. Plus, these are the hottest records of the choice. Just always one's got to be better than the other, apparently, for this particular discussion.
Right.
So I mean, got to wait. They're both tied up because both, you know, both guys are voting for each record, but nobody has laid a vote down yet.
All right. So then I'll put my vote down.
Check this out before you do that. My bad. Hobo, we never got to find out what the actual winners were in the voting booths for all three rounds before that. Do we know what the actual results were before we move on?
So in the first round, it was tied.
Okay.
Second round went to Ill Bomb. Narrowly. And then in the last round, it went to I'm Bad.
I'm Bad. Ike, you heard the results.
First round was tied.
First round was tied. Interesting. Exactly. You hear the results of the first three rounds. Maybe it might help you decide what you think should go to the last and final win. Who do you got, bro?
I mean, I'm probably going to start off Street FM with I'm Bad. You know what I mean? When I go on the air live tonight at 12 a.m. You know, WUSB.FM for those who want to listen worldwide.
Tell him.
Yeah, you know what I mean?
That's right.
I'll check that man out.
I got my man, DC3. I am Strong Island coming through the building tonight as a guest. But I think I'm going to have to vote for Jigglin' Baby because I'm so mad because I thought I was going to have that record and win. And as we get to the final round, I love I'm Bad, but I think, I mean, my uncle might be mad at me, but man, I'm gonna just have to go with him, Jigglin' Baby.
You going with Jigglin' Baby?
Yeah, man.
Oh, something you said. I thought you said the opposite, but okay. Well, this one I heard you say. Okay, fair enough. We got still the first vote in the room. Ike Infamous going with Jigglin' Baby. Does anybody agree or disagree?
I'm gonna have to go with Jigglin' Baby as well. I mean, I'm Bad is my joint as well, but just don't want to see Hobo win this round, but it's okay, man. Jigglin' Baby.
Do what I did. Don't attach him to the record. Just think of the record.
Okay. Wow. Thank you.
Think of the record. I mean, you could associate Jigglin' Baby with being a Munch record. No, if that makes it easier to vote.
Wow, so Jigglin' Baby's a Munch record now?
In 2023, okay. Gotcha.
No. Okay.
Now I got to listen to the song differently now.
All right. Wow. This is so stupid.
Yo, go ahead, Trent.
Yeah, I'm going with I'm Bad because that was a career-defining track for him.
It was.
Yeah, indeed.
Again, so I had to screw so much stuff. People switching sides here. We got Hobo's vote. We got DJ Scandalous's vote. We got Ike Infamous's vote. We got Cool Breeze's vote. Triple C's vote. Malcontent, where do you stand there, brother? What do you think?
So this could end up being a tie, huh?
It's going to end up being a chat room decision breaker.
You got Malcontent the power now. You got
Malcontent
the
power. Malcontent is at the 18th hole right now.
He's, I think I'll go with I'm Bad, then.
I was going to take it.
Let's see what the people think. I'm Bad. Let's see what the people think.
Malcontent putting this vote down, making a tie happen, which makes total sense. Again, LL, you're
talking. These are two great songs, man. Let's let the chat room decide.
Chat room, can we get the voting booth going one more game? Let's talk
about it. They already voted.
Oh, they already voted?
I don't have the power, dude.
Get the drum roll going. DJ Hobo, what were the results of the voting booth?
The voting booth has decided that I'm Bad is the winner for the evening.
You heard it live. Give it up one time. The overall winner, the best LL Cool J records of all time. I'm Bad.
Beautiful. I love how that turned out.
But you know what's so crazy is that I could have ended it with I'm Bad, my round.
Nobody forgot that you had that power, man. Like, you don't gotta do your push-ups, man. Like,
I did. I forgot.
It felt good for a second. I can't lie.
It felt good.
But pause. Yeah.
I mean, no homes. But I'm saying, like, yeah. I probably would act the same way if I was ever in a position where I could feel like I'm rigging the game. Son of a bitch. I get kicked out all the time.
Listen, man.
This was dope, man. I mean, dope. The thing is, too, we only did like the way when we started off, right? Like we
couldn't even touch it.
We could have went to because like I had Lounging as another record I was going to do because that's a club banger. That's a huge record.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I was like, it depends on what direction we wanted to take this in.
Yeah, man.
That would make for the obvious win.
Which singles were best of his for like 10 years, 5 years. You could have just took boom, boom, boom and pick out singles from that shit.
We could have done only a genre of club bangers, only a genre of like underground, mixtape type joints.
LL Cool J love songs by themselves.
That's how great of a career he's had, man. He can do all those different genres of hip hop and have a legit.
That's the kind of career he's having, not even had that he's having. I mean, keep in mind, he's supposed to be dropping a whole new project with Q-Tip. So it's like,
That's right.
And then at the same time, being a big, humongous movie actor, TV star, you know what I'm saying? So
he has time.
Like it. Love it.
Show canceled.
I cringed when I heard DJ's gonna say that.
And yo, his show did get canceled, but let's keep it real. That show was on for a long time.
He
has time to do another album.
Think about this. Just on TV alone, just on TV alone, there are grandparents that sit down and think about LL Cool J being a part of their daily watch TV. It has no connection to him being involved with anything hip hop, bro.
How ironic that is him and Ice-T that have the same type of like longevity with TV shows. Isn't that crazy?
Jake Reed,
beef with
each other? No cop.
Crazy.
No cop Jake Reed.
Crazy.
Listen, let's talk about this real. We obviously wrapped up the game, shot the LL, obviously. We're going to go ahead and quickly go around the room real quick. Hope, I don't know if you want to maybe get the raid going. And then we can, like I said, just find out what everybody's kind of choices were. Like, we're going to go through it kind of fast. What was everybody's sort of second or third pick? You don't have to go through too many because we said there's a lot. So just give me your first or second last pick. You know, if you want to go through it. Triple C, what were your other picks besides the record you brought to the table?
I had Candy.
Great.
I had the L-Bomb. And I had the Queens. Queens Is. Featuring
Five. Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, that was a dope record.
I think Havoc did that too, if I'm not mistaken. I think Havoc did that.
Yeah, Havoc.
Yeah, that was a dope record.
You had a dope pick. I get from this. What'd you get?
So literally, I had Jiggling Baby as my first choice, and then I had I'm Bad as my second, and then I had Ill Bomb as my third. Like, I didn't think anything past that. Yeah, like I literally was down to my last. But I mean,
fair enough.
I think we mentioned it before. Backseat of My Jeep was a dope record.
Yeah.
And God, I'm forgetting. 4-3-2-1.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
It's not a single, but it's not necessarily him by himself. But
there's
another record that I'm forgetting. There's another record that I'm forgetting.
I'll say the record.
Which one is it?
Can I give mine now?
Yeah.
Are you thinking Booming System?
Yeah.
Wow!
Wow, that was a dope one.
Right there,
Booming System.
Yeah, that's another one. Holy shit!
So I'm sorry. Go ahead.
I'm done. No, okay. No,
you speak. Well, shout out to DJS619 in the building. He's taking 4-3-2-1. Now, what were you thinking?
Yeah, I'm gonna say Booming System. I mentioned Going Back to Cali. I mean, you know, I already picked, you know, Jack the Ripper. I love Lounging. I think Lounging is just. Lounge remix is just like a perfect.
Yeah.
The remix of Lounge. Yeah. Was there one more? I mean, there's just so many, but I'll just leave it at that. I mean, that's Booming System is my joint though.
Booming System is fire.
And going back to Kelly, man, that's just classic. Right? Going back to Kelly, dang, that was was it Less Than Zero soundtrack?
Damn. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Mm. Long time ago.
Oh, what were you thinking? Less Than Zero soundtrack. That's great.
So for me,
I'm doing it. And Milky cereal.
Mm.
And going back to Cali.
Mm.
Honorable mention to I Shot You.
Right.
Original. Right. Yeah. Remix, right?
The remix with Prodigy on it.
Yeah, with everybody. Scan, what are you thinking?
I had, ironically, I had Lounging and doing it because of those were different angles. You know what I mean? For those type of records. So that's why I picked those. And then going back to Cali, I had that, but I had that more for sort of the rock rated DMC set and how he flipped that. You know what I mean? So so that will always be one of my favorite routines as a battle DJ, man.
Right. Shout out to Mr. Summer. He said, "Hey, Love and Paradise are still official."
Paradise is a fucking record. What's
the joint with the
Neptunes? What's the joint with who?
Joint with the Neptunes beat.
I love you better.
I love you.
That is my joint. Yo,
love you better.
That would have been an ill twist in the game if somebody said that one. Like, oh,
don't forget Pink Cookies. Nobody said Pink Cookies.
Yeah.
The remix was
the B
remix, is that what it was?
He did remix it too.
We didn't, even though we just did this song not too long ago, but Mama Said Knock You Out.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
No head spin.
I'm glad you mentioned
all his from my Timberland.
Well, yeah. Matter of fact, wait, hold on. Wait, real quick, Triple C. Who didn't get a chance to go? Trip, you want to read or no?
I didn't.
Oh, Breeze, what about who you got? Who do you have your choice?
First was Jiggling Baby. I had Rock the Bells. That's the one I picked. Going back to Cali, I Can't Live Without My Radio, and 4321. I just put those down.
All right. I like all these choices. Plus, shout out to everybody in the chat room that's been dropping names as well all night. I mean,
props for bringing up Milky Cereal, man. I just love the wordplay on that joint, man.
Milky Cereal.
That's a classic.
Fire, man.
Yeah, I'm just glad we had the opportunity to talk about LL. Yeah, I wanted to talk about LL for the longest.
Yeah, word.
Yo,
LL was dope. I know we got to go, but I just want to say, like, when we started talking about doing this one, I know I was like, nah, we can't do LL because it's going to be more than one round, but yo, we really could do another round with LL.
not to cut you off, Jules, I sent everybody the link for the Kumo D Redman song as well, too.
Mm-hmm. I saw that, yeah.
Check that out.
I don't know if you want to play that as we're fading out.
Rocking with the best.
How you playing that when we're talking about LL?
Are you?
That's a good point. That's a good point, Tripp. That's a good point.
But here's the thing. Kumo D went against LL. So, you know, we're just trying to give him his flowers while he's around.
That we do that in a Kumo D episode.
How you like me now?
Executive director, cool Triple C.
Damn, Tripp.
I used to be downtown.
Out of here. See y'all next Monday. One more game.
Yo, you now rocking with the best. I'm blessed, I deliver well. That's why I'm up in the SUPS. Through rain, sleet, or snow, I never break down. My skin made of Gore-Tex. Heard Reggie went left. Cause when I do right, folks out of spite, only give me a few mics. Three best MCs, time for new life. Let the streets decide on who nice.
You see, he's out there, everybody in the chat room.
Money in the banker.
Thanks for coming through again. See y'all next week.
$1 million boss dictating what I think. This shooter's getting real nervous in the paint. 5-star would I rank like Lea Mataj. Girls looking like Nicki Minaj. Reggie, hip-hop, I rock steady. Just check my clout. When Jersey in the building, I rock the house. Yeah. Yeah. You now rockin' with the best. One of the best. Best for me. Wow, look so fresh. We gon' get something straight here in the place to be. Hey, they ask me how I maintain the rap game in the streets. I can picture in the same frame. You ain't wrong, you don't ball, so lose yourself. Trying to keep up when I change lanes. My weed game green, clientele is swell. It's cool like LL, the barge looking like brother. Time will reveal that I'm doing it and doing it well. Even if you read braille, you can feel my swag. I'm your CNI dog with the pen in the pad. Blue collar, when I talk, you can tell. crush on up how much money you can fit in the bag. My gift is the gab, the streets the truth. They got a little lost when down south came through. I stayed in the booth.
Yeah.
There's the Modiverse.
He's like, hell talking about the heaven. Yeah, it was him.
Stop streaming.